Our next topic is quadratic time complexity. To recap, quadratic time represents an algorithm whose performance is directly proportional to the square of the size of the input dataset. As you can see in this graph, the runtime increases sharply faster than the input sizes. The runtime of an algorithm with quadratic time complexity will go up as a square of the input dataset size. Quadratic, cubic, and quartic time complexities are a result of nested operations on a dataset. You should try to avoid them whenever possible due to the negative impact on overall performance. Let's say your quadratic time algorithm processes 100 entries in 100 milliseconds. For 2000 entries, the algorithm would run for 40 seconds. And 4000 entries would be processed in slightly more than 26 minutes. The runtime would grow even more sharply with the input size in the case of cubic or quartic time complexity. In the following demo, we are going to build a function that creates multiplication tables. The function will use two nested loops. Because of the nested iterations, this algorithm has a quadratic time complexity. Now, let's switch to Xcode. First, we implement a useful addition to our benchmarking utility. We add a formatted time property to the CF time interval type. This property provides a concise string representation of the time interval value, which also includes the right unit of time, which ranges from nanoseconds to seconds. Let's implement a function to demonstrate the quadratic time complexity. The multiTable function takes an integer argument, which gives the size of the array which holds positive integers in the range 1 to size. The function returns the results of multiplying each element in the array with every other value. We use two loops to compute the result. The outer loop iterates through the indices of the array. The internal loop takes the value found at the outer index and multiplies it with every item from the same array. The output is a multiplication table. Let's check out what we get for the input value 10. Now, let's analyze how the two nested loops influence the processing time. For a two-element array, the outer loop iterates two times, and the internal loop also two times for every outer iteration. This gives us four iterations in total. For a three-element array, the total iteration count is 3 times 3, that is 9. For 10 elements, the function will loop 100 times. The number of iterations goes up as a square of the input data size. Let's run some performance tests to prove that our function runs at quadratic time complexity. We call the multiTable function with arrays of different sizes and will display the runtimes in the console. The numbers are convincing. We can clearly see the quadratic jumps in the execution time. It is worth mentioning that, especially for smaller input, the measurements might not always reflect the quadratic time complexity because of under-the-hood compiler and hardware optimizations.